Cartoonito Tales, Peter and the Wolf. Hannah and Peter love playing together, like all brothers and sisters do. Hannah likes to pretend this blue rug is a frozen pond for her little rubber ducks to skate on. But sometimes Peter doesn't want to play with the ducks. He'd rather practice his tickling. He stretches out his fingers, gives them a wiggle, and tickles Hannah. Hannah giggles and giggles, and Peter tickles and tickles, until she drops her little baby duck. It flies through the air and lands straight down a mouse hole. Hannah tries very hard not to get upset. She knows Peter didn't do it on purpose. The little duck is Hannah's favourite. Peter feels just awful for losing it. So he reaches into the mouse hole to find it. And as he does, something very curious happens. The little mouse hole begins to grow bigger and bigger. As soon as there is enough room, Peter crawls right in. Hannah is a little worried about what might be inside, but she doesn't want to be left all on her own, so she follows him in. On the other side of the little mouse hole, there is a beautiful forest. The tall, towering trees reach up to the sky. The air is filled with the sweet smell of daisies and daffodils. But despite all this, Hannah still feels worried.
"I don't like it here. It's cold and strange," she says.
Luckily, Peter finds them some lovely warm coats to wear. But even with her new coat on, Hannah doesn't like being in the forest.
"Let's just find my duck and go home," she says.
"But there's so much to explore,"
says Peter as he scampers off into the forest.
"Don't go too far, Peter," she says. "It'll be getting dark soon."
Peter chuckles. Hannah is always worrying about silly things.
"It won't get dark for ages,"
he says. Hannah chases after him. But what's this? Yellow feathers? Big wet feet? Why, it's Hannah's little duck. Hannah and Peter are so happy they've found the little duck.
"I found my duck. Now let's go home," says Hannah.
But the little duck wants to play a game. Hannah and Peter chase her round and round the trees. They're starting to get dizzy when Hannah catches hold of her little tail. But the little duck quacks. She wriggles and flaps until she pulls her tail free. Then she waddles off as fast as she can. Hannah and Peter chase after her.
"Come back, little duck,"
they shout. The little duck wants Hannah and Peter to meet her very best friend, Mr. Cat. They are very pleased to meet him. The little duck and Mr. Cat love playing tag.
"Would you like to play with us, Hannah and Peter?"
Mr. Cat asks.
"Oh, yes please,
they say. They have lots of fun chasing each other round and round the trees. After all that running, they are completely out of puff, so they sit down for a little rest. But Peter doesn't like sitting quietly for too long. He runs back into the forest, ready to play some more.
"Wait for us, Peter!"
shouts Hannah. Mr. Cat and Peter love climbing trees. They have a competition to see who can climb the highest. Hannah and the little duck love picking flowers. They smell just lovely. Look at all the pretty colours. There's pink, purple, red and blue. They're having so much fun, they don't notice it's starting to get dark. Then they hear a terrible howling and yowling in the distance.
"What was that?" asks Hannah.
"It's the wolf," says Mr. Cat.
He climbs up high into the treetops, safely hidden from the wolf.
"Come quickly, you must get home," says the little duck.
She leads Hannah and Peter through the forest. The howling grows louder and louder. Hannah and Peter begin to run. They look very scared. The little duck waddles and waddles as fast as her little flippers will carry her, but she can't keep up.
The wolf creeps closer and closer, and then he gobbles up the poor little duck.
"Yummy, yummy in my tummy," says the wolf.
Then he runs into the forest before Hannah can stop him. Peter looks around for Hannah. He has an idea.
"I'm going to save the little duck," he says bravely.
"You can't go back into the forest," says Hannah.
"The wolf will eat you too."
But there's no stopping him. So Hannah summons all her courage and shouts,
"I'll help you, Peter."
Hannah and Peter tell Mr. Cat all about their plan to save the little duck from the wolf's tummy. Mr. Cat promises to help. They work very hard to make a very special trap. A trap for catching wicked wolves who eat little ducks. Hannah collects up lots of sticks. Mr. Cat and Peter tie them together with shoelaces. In no time at all, the trap is finished. They heave it up into the branches. Now they are ready to catch the wolf. Hannah and Peter hide behind the trees. They hold on tight to the shoelaces. Mr. Cat pretends to be stuck in the mud.
"Help, I'm stuck,"
he shouts.
"Quickly, before the wolf eats me too."
The wolf falls for the trick. He comes running through the forest, ready for his pudding. Brave Mr. Cat scampers away. Peter lets go of the shoelace and the trap comes crashing down. They have caught the wolf. They are so happy to hear the little muffled quacks coming from inside his tummy. Peter stretches out his fingers and gives them a wiggle. Then he reaches through the bars and tickles the wolf's tummy.
The wolf tries very hard not to laugh, but Peter is just too good at tickling. A little snigger slips out, then a giggle, and then a big belly laugh.
The wolf laughs and laughs until the little duck comes flying out.
She is so happy to be free. It was damp and dark inside the wolf's tummy. But what are they to do with the wolf? Luckily, Hannah has a very good idea.
"We'll let you out if you promise to leave the woods and never come back ever again," she says.
The wolf doesn't like the sound of that at all. But being stuck in the trap forever would be much worse. So he promises to leave and never ever come back. Hannah, true to her word, lets the wolf out. He runs into the forest, never to be seen ever again.
Hooray! Hooray!
They cheer.
Bravo, everyone,
says Mr. Cat.
You are all very brave.
There's just enough time to play one more game. Before long, it's time for Hannah and Peter to go home. They wave goodbye to Mr. Cat and the little duck before climbing through the mouse hole. Hannah and Peter are very glad to be back home. But they miss their new friends terribly.
Look! On the rug sit all three ducks back together again.
And who's this? Why, it's a little toy cat. Hannah and Peter are so happy. They play together all afternoon, making the little ducks and the little cats skate across the blue rug pond.